Hi, I'm here to show you how to crimp an EZ-RJ45 Cat6 connector with the EZ-RJ45 Crimp Tool from Platinum Tools, which simultaneously cuts and crimps your wires. An RJ45 connector is a standard 8-pin connector with 8 positions and contacts, and is commonly used for Ethernet patch cables. An Ethernet patch cable connects two different devices, like a computer to a router. Before I show you how to use this tool to crimp a Cat6 connector, let's talk about the differences between T568A and T568B wire pinout standards. It's easy to tell the difference between the two standards just by looking at them. The standard and most common pinout is the T568B. This always starts with the white-orange wire at the far left. The T568A, which is really only used by government entities, starts off with the white-green wire. The wiring lineup for T568B is white-orange, orange, white-green, blue, white-blue, green, white-brown, and then brown. T568A is white-green, green, white-orange, blue, white-blue, orange, white-brown, and then brown. The same pinout order needs to be used on both ends of your Cat6 connector cable, or else your connectors won't be able to communicate. When they are the same, it's what you call a straight-through cable. If you have T568B in your wall jack, you need to have the same sequence for your Cat6 connector. The only time you'd pair the two different pinouts on separate ends of the same cable is when you have two like devices, like two computers that need to communicate. This is what is called a crossover cable, which has one end with T568A and the other with T568B pinouts. The first thing you'll need to do is remove around 2 inches of the jacket cable to expose the wiring you plan to work with. Don't score the jacket too deep or it could cut into the wiring. Untwist and straighten each of the wires, placing them into the T568B or T568A pinout order. Hold the wires in order between your fingers. It's important that you remove all the kinks in the wires, keeping them side by side without any gaps. This will prevent crosstalk. If you find any of the wires are not in the correct pinout order, it's important to arrange them accurately before you crimp them. Next, you can use the built-in wire cutter on the EZ-RJ45 crimp tool to trim all the wire ends to make sure all the conductors are of equal length. You'll then gently insert all the wires into the EZ-RJ45 connector, pulling the connector down over the cable jacket. The cable jacket should be seated snugly into the rear of the connector. Don't get discouraged if you don't get this right on your first try. It can take some practice. It's recommended to double check that your wires are in the correct pinout order at this time. Push the EZ-RJ45 connector into the EZ-RJ45 crimp tool, placing the connector fully into the crimp cavity. Your final step is to use the crimp tool by squeezing the handles together to crimp and trim the wires, which keeps the wires and connector together. If you have any remaining loose wires, you can simply break them off. Do a final inspection of your crimped wires to make sure the wire jacket is seated into the connector. You also need to make sure the wires are properly attached to the pins and crimped down for the best connection. Click the links below in the video description to read more on Cable Organizer about the EZ-RJ45 crimp tool, Cat6 connectors, and T568A and T568B wire pinout standards.
Cable Organizer, your life organized.